During the mid-90s, Hollywood tried to bring our favorite video game franchises to the big screen. All I can say is, whoever wrote and directed Super Mario Bros., Mortal Kombat Annihilation, and Double Dragon ought to be shot, hung, stabbed, poisoned, and shit on. By now you're probably thinking, hey, he forgot a movie. This is true. There was another video game movie that was made in the 90s. Well, Skippy, that's the subject of this review. Now, to my knowledge, and I could be wrong, and I'm hoping someone does correct me. Now, this is a video game that's based on a movie that's based on a video game. Everybody get that? This is a video game based on a movie based on a video game. It's Street Fighter the Movie for the Sega Saturn. Watch if you dare. We all remember the original Street Fighter 2 game, right? And I'm sure 6 out of 10 people know about the Street Fighter movie released in 1994, starring Jean-Claude Van Damme. Funny how even though the movie bombed, they still made a video game out of it anyway. Now, it was first made into an arcade game before being ported over to the Sega Saturn. I'm not impressed with either version. Let's now talk about the Saturn version, which is the one we're looking at here. You got a couple of options here. The movie mode takes you through the story of the Street Fighter movie. Well, sorta. Somehow I don't remember the scene where Guile fights Balrog. During the fighting, you'll see what appears to be promotional movie stills of the movie actors and some dialogue below. For some reason, these characters have reason to kick your ass, so a fight begins. If you win, they'll give you some information that'll lead you to M. Bison. You also got Cammy helping you... What the hell? That's the funniest damn thing I've ever seen. Holy shit. I can have some fun with this. Mamma mia, mamma mia. Mamma mia, let me go. Okay, that's enough of that. Now then, Cammy here, she'll advise you on where to go or who to talk to for information. Moving on to the other options, the street battle lets you select from one of the 14 characters and you fight whoever the CPU designates. Unless you're duking it out in the two-player mode, then you have more of a say. Trial fighting is absolutely useless to me, so I'm not even going to bother explaining it to you guys. I'm just going to review this piece of trash. Now, the graphics are supposed to be digitized from the film. That's a good thing, right? Hell no! I'm sure some fluidity could have been pulled off here, but it doesn't look that way, does it? The opening FMV intro looks like someone took a compressed MPEG of the actual Street Fighter movie and just slapped some random scenes together. Don't even get me started on the scenes involving Cammy talking. It makes me wonder if the real actors actually play this game or not. Some shitload of cash must have been dumped in their laps. Probably a few gold bars, too. Wouldn't surprise me. Moving right along, the sound. Something else I'm sure the film actors did not participate in. In some ways, it might be for the best. Can you imagine Van Damme spouting Sonic Boom with a straight face? I think not. If you listen closely, you can tell the music tracks fade out and then loop all over again. Gee, all the jazzy, digitized characters and all this gosh darn amazing background action must have left no room on the disc for longer music tracks. Well, could be that or just pure f***ing laziness. Doesn't seem all that hard to perform some of the special moves for each character, though. You got the usual punches and kicks. Some of the actual moves look very unconvincing and oftentimes seriously weak. You're not really going to be frustrated with the controls as you will with the increasing challenge. In the movie mode of this game, you're on a time limit of about 50 hours to defeat all the opponents in the game before reaching Bison. If you're defeated, you lose about an hour or so. Once time runs out, the game is over. Otherwise, you'll just have to keep fighting the same guy who kicked your sorry behind 26 times while fighting the urge to throw this game into a live volcano. I like those guys who review the bad video games and then destroy them. I can't bring myself to do that, despite the fact that this particular game blew chunks. See, it helps to have games like this that just tell people, hey, this concept's been done before and it just doesn't seem to work. Now if only Hollywood would apply that logic to making the video games into movies to begin with. Yeah, that ain't gonna sink in anytime soon. Toss this game and let's pretend it doesn't exist. We'll see you later.